Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. When last we left off, well, we walked down to the shoreline. The water looks clean and inviting, though it is almost certainly freezing cold. In the far distance, boats punt this way and that between scattered islands. Now, we had put up to a vote three of these, and this is the nature of the series. At the end of the video, you are presented a list of choices, like choose your own adventure, and you can vote for which choice you like. And the majority vote was to call out for a boat. And you know what I'm thinking? I'm not completely sure about this, but I think the whistle is to summon a giant bird, which you've seen a few times in this section of the game, in this chapter or whatever. And the bird takes us to the mountain where the Archmage is, or the mountaintop where the Archmage is. Sorry guys, coughing and... Okay. So I'm really curious to blow the whistle, but you guys voted for call out for the boat. And besides, I don't want to go to the end just yet. We haven't even defeated half the serpents. I think 3 out of 7. So we're going to call out for a boat. You call out for a boat, but they are well out of earshot. A few nearby people look at you strangely. Okay, now I'm going to blow the whistle. I just don't want it to bring us all the way to the end, because we have not defeated these serpents yet. You take out the whistle and blow it, but nothing happens. Presumably, as there is no ferryman here, at least not in this time. Does it say what the... You know, I should have looked at that. Maybe I didn't. I forgot. No, it just says it's a simple brass whistle. Doesn't say what it's for. Well, okay, I'm going to swim across the lake then. Because I do want to get across the island. I'm not very happy swimming across this lake, especially since it was this huge piranha thing that we had to zap with lightning to kill. The lake is wider than the eye can see. To swim across it might take an entire day, but you cannot be sure. This I should have left up to a vote. Okay, yeah, 5-minute video, guys. What do you guys think? Let's... Can I swim an entire day? It's going to tax my stamina down, isn't it? Maybe I can find another way across? Well, you can't go here, though. You're limited by where the game will let you go. I would cross the Tin Pang River. Probably there, which looks like... Maybe it's narrowest point, or maybe all the way up there. I'd probably cross there. So, like, in real life terms, I would cross there, so I have to walk all the way up there. And then I would cross here. You know, we could probably teleport to this one. But I do want to get to these islands, definitely. I don't know. If there was an obvious other way across, I would take that. I can levitate, right? But not for an entire day. We're not given an option to cast a spell. I'm gonna swim it. I took a ration. Oh, I lost a ration. There's nothing for it then, you seems. You step down to the water's edge. Do what you can to secure your pack, and then dive in. On the docks, people stop and stare and point, but you ignore them, settling into an efficient stroke. At least the water is warm. That's good. Of course, all your water-damageable possessions have been ruined. Thankfully, however, the pages of your spellbook is protected, but all of your soft food has been ruined. Damn it. Thank you. assuming the cloth skull cap will be fine. I don't know if I have much paper things. I shouldn't even have this note, actually. So I lost rations. I have cooked fish and 2 joints of meat. I guess I lost... I think I got fruit or something. Well, that's me. I thought this was a dragon, with this side being, you know, the neck and the head of the dragon. Away from shore. We're halfway there. You fall into an steady stroke into the water. After so long walking, it's almost a pleasant change to swim. Yeah, rest for the feet. Or the soles of the feet, anyway. The day is likely to be clear and will be hot once more. The water is strangely thick and curiously buoyant. It seems to keep you afloat with little effort required, but the same buoyancy makes moving through the water hard work. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. On the lake. Well, I don't want to go this way or that. I want to go here. This way. You swim on through the water. It is exhausting work. As the sun climbs towards its zenith, the winds pick up. A shoal of brightly colored fish pass by just under the surface. One nips at your fingers with tiny teeth. Watch them. You watch as one tiny fish clamps your thumb with tiny, needle-like teeth and sucks a few drops of blood. Not sure if I should be eating these raw fish. Just crush it? Oh, I lost stamina. You crush it in your fist and shake the carcass off into the water. The rest of the shoal immediately turns about and approaches you on the attack. Great. Well, I could splash them. That would be helpful, wouldn't it? So, as I'm praying for aid, cast a spell. Let's try to see what spells we have available. I've got... Turn to stone. Imagine a whole bunch of little stone fish. That'd actually be adorable, wouldn't it? Yeah, I can read their minds. They want to eat me. They're hungry. I don't really need to read their minds. This is, float in the air. I'm really leaning towards that. I mean, that's really kind of what I wanted to do in the first place. This is fix, I think? Yeah. Fixedness? I don't have that. Oops, stop. Or I can... Yeah, create lightning while I am also in the water. Right, no, I'm gonna skip that. Did I do L? Control non-intelligent creatures. I would do this, except it requires 3 stamina. I don't want to save that. It'd be cool if I could actually control them. Make, like, if there's enough of them, make, like, a bed or a life raft out of them. And just lay on them. And let them swim you to shore. In unified swimming. Let's... synchronize swimming with little fish. Let's float in the air. And maybe I can just walk the rest of the way there. And avoid these freaking things. This requires 1 stamina, but at least it's not 3. Oh, really? You cast a spell, lightening your body weight to a mere fraction of normal. In the water, it makes little difference, however. I can't see attacking these tiny things with my... I was about to say my stamina went down again, but that's the 1 stamina from the foul spell. Fail. Foul fail. I'm gonna pray for aid, because... Yeah, how am I gonna defeat all these tiny little fish with my sword? You close your eyes and raise a prayer to Korga. Nothing seems to happen. Then, a moment later, the water around turns freezing cold. To your relief, the shoal turns about in a flash and is gone. You swim quickly away before they can return. Okay. Near the island. Bloodthirsty little things in this lake. You float on across the surface of the lake. Your weight returns and you settle gradually back down to the ground. No, I don't. I'm not on the ground. I wasn't by the ground. I'm near some ground, but yeah, I never even left the surface of the water. The mid-afternoon heat fills the region. You pause for a moment, treading water and catching your breath. The size of the lake is beginning to dawn on you. Just keep swimming. But thinking about it can do no good. You set your mind to swimming. You have swum within reach of the bay of a low island. You will need to go to shore and recover. 12 stamina, wow. Gratefully doing so. You haul yourself gratefully up onto the shoreline. The sun has reached its highest point now. Out of the shade, the air is baking hot. The island is rocky and barren. In the center is a rise of land from which a tree grows. In the shallow stands a tall pole from which hangs a bell. Look at the bell. The bell is set with a silver clapper attached to a rope. The wind shifts for a moment, bringing with it a terrible stench. Then the smell is gone. Should I rest first, then? If we're ringing a bell, I don't know what's going to do. Gonna call something. Let's rest and recover. You seat yourself by the lake shore to meditate and recover your strength. The sun begins to dip, heading toward the horizon. Yay, almost back to full. You get to your feet, feeling much better. Ring the bell. Yeah, before I explore and then ring the bell. Oh, hello. You tug the rope and the bell rings with a clear and steady chime. After a few minutes, a boat slides out of the mist and of the lake toward you. The ferryman hops down into the shallows. Greetings, he calls. You'll be wanting to cross Lake Ilklala, will you? Look at him. You pause to look over the ferryman. He is a scruffy, unwashed individual, somewhat overweight, but with the shoulders of an ox, and he no doubt needs to pole across the water all day. What's your price, you ask? 6 gold pieces, he says calmly. Take it or I'll leave you. I don't want to leave yet. I want to explore, so I'll tell him it's too much. It's too much, you tell him. He shrugs and pushes the boat out into the shallows. Wave him off. You wave him away. He shrugs and pulls off across the lake once more. Alright, let's explore inland. So I guess when you ring that bell again, he might come back. You leave the shoreline and head inland. Look! Inland! Huh. You circle the shoreline of the island to the north as you climb your way up the rising stones. The stones are bare and gray. This island appears to be desolate. Explore across the rocks. You explore across the rocks, feeling careful not to slip and twist your ankle in any of the cracks. Perhaps this is no island at all, but simply a mountain peak that has slid down into the water. That's technically what an island is. Mountains, I mean, for the most part, right? Mountains under the water that come up out of the peak is out of the water. Whatever. Let's look under the rocks. You peer underneath one of the piles of rocks but can make out nothing but more rocks and shadowy dark. There may be snakes down there, but not gigantic winged serpents. That's because we're in the past. The serpents are in the present. Exploring across the rocks, you come across a rough staircase of stones. It curves around and upwards into the heart of the island. Well, we have to explore, right? We have to check it out. I'm thankful I have almost full stamina, plenty of gold, and actually 3 rations. We're, like, rich from, like, compared to the rest of this entire chapter to the middle of last episode, we are rich. Well, so we've got to climb the staircase, or climb down a staircase. You begin to climb the stone staircase. It is unclear if it is natural or designed. Oh, we're climbing up. Oh. Around and upwards, got it. All right. Interesting how we look under rocks. You have to look under rocks to find a staircase that goes up. Weird. You clamber up and over the edge of the stony pit. There is a single bare tree at the pit's heart. But tied to the tree, head slumped forward, is a Sightmaster. His eyes are shut, but still he calls out, "Stay away! Stay away!" Look around. You look around the clearing for any signs of traps, but there are none. The rocks are barren. Even the tree is dead. "What is the danger?" you call, from the edge of the clearing, not quite daring to approach. The Sightmaster sobs in reply, his eyes still firmly shut. "Please just stay away. Leave. Leave me." "I will not leave you." The Sightmaster stops short in his crying and tilts his head. "Is that you?" he breathes. "Annalander, is that you?" You recognize his voice, of course. This is none other than the sergeant-at-arms from Annaland. "Really? Who spied the path ahead for you when you crossed the wall?" He has none of his magnificent strength about him now. "Wow." "Yeah, I do vaguely remember him. Yeah, from the beginning, the tutorial, training and stuff. I'm not sure if I trained with him or someone else, but I do remember talking to a sergeant." "It is I," you murmur. The Sightmaster shakes his horn helmet in despair. "You should not have come," he insists. "I tried to shout. I hoped you would turn back if you heard me." "What is the danger?" The Sightmaster's body racks with a sudden pain. "Annalander, how I long to look upon your face. You would be of great comfort to me." "Then look." The Sightmaster shakes his head. "Do not tempt me. Do not." What the hell's he talking about? "Do not tempt him to look at us. If I look at it, if he looks at us, something bad will happen." "What happened to you?" you ask, horrified. The Sightmaster shakes his head pitifully. His eyes, you notice, are still firmly closed. "The worst thing that can be done to such as I," he murmurs. "How long have you been out here?" He's not really answering our questions. "I was captured by Birdman a week ago. They flew me to this point, tied me up, and left me. But that is not all they did." He begins to sob once more. The Sightmaster gasps suddenly. "Please," he gasps. "You must leave. I cannot stay like this much longer. I must look. I must. My eyes are on fire. Not to look. It is like not breathing." Yeah, he's ensorcelled. "The Archmage did this to you?" you demand furiously. "The Archmage did this to you?" Yeah, that's better. "He is mad, Annalander. They say he is more terrified of you than of anything. He only wishes to see you killed, and he does not care how it is done. Even those that follow him are afraid of him now. That is why he has taken the crown." "I will get the crown back." "Do not underestimate its power," he replies. "The crown is lined with jewels of gold and bone circlets, and its horns are shaped with spines that channel starlight. It is a grimalkin, a machine of magic. It channels spells of worship and illusion. Whoever wears it can control the will of all they see, without effort or skill." "I am going to cut your bonds. I can't leave him. Obviously, if he looks at me, something happens. Monsters, fire, death, something like that. Out of his eyes, I don't know. I'm going to cut his bonds." The Sightmaster nods. "Do so. But do so quickly. And then run. I have kept my eyes shut for 7 days. You cannot imagine the pain of it. I cannot keep them closed for much longer. But what happens if you open them? You perhaps know of the red eyes of Kari, he answers. If I open these lids, what is behind them will burn everything they see. His voice turns to darkness. But I am a Sightmaster, he continues. You hurry over to the man and slice through the bonds that hold his arms against the tree. The Archmage knew you would come this way, he breathes. He knew you would search the islands on your journey. I am not the only trap that awaits. You must tell me what you know. He gulps, about to vomit from pain. Beware the other islands, he continues. For on one waits the most powerful of the seven serpents, the Serpent of Time himself. Beware. He means to kill you. How can I defeat the Time Serpent? The Sightmaster shakes his head. I do not think he can be defeated, for he is faster than time itself. I heard the Birdman say this. Stay away from him, Outlander. His freed eyes are lifting to rub his face. Cover his eyes? Seem a good idea, so I'll burn with fire? Quickly you tear a strip of cloth from his cloak and bind it around his eyes. But the Sightmaster shakes his head. My eyes carry the power of the Under-Earth, he insists. A mere strip of cloth will do nothing. Run, Outlander, run! Remember, I can see far. Oh, okay. Let's run for it. Thank you for all that you have gave me in my training, you tell him. Oh, that's me talking. Thank you for all that you gave me in my training, you tell him firmly. You clasp his shoulder once, then turn and scramble away down the stony gully. The Sightmaster's gasping breath echoes after you. You head back to the shore. Clues updated. Oh, it's there. Okay. Right. And the other one's here. But we have to turn... I'm pretty sure it's right around here. We have to turn the dial back away from the village. Also turn it back into normal time. So we've got... Didn't I know where one more was? Oh, it was one here. The Earth Serpent we defeated, I guess so. Okay, so we got one here. Like a gold kind of dragon, I think. And one here. So that's dragons 4 and 5. Now I bear about 6 or 7. Okay, so clues, right. I went out, really, to also look at clues. A clue! A clue! Time Serpent is on an island, waiting on an island in the middle of Lake Ilklala, the most powerful of them all. Alright, let's back to the shore. How far can he see? What, are we back in... I guess we're back in the present? In this area? You return to the shore of the lake. The pole with the bell marks the edge of the water. The Sightmaster's desperate whimpering is carried to you for just a moment on the breeze. Black, gloomy clouds roll across the sky, flowing from the east. So I'm guessing... It still looks... I guess it ends... It looks like it ends right before the island. If I turn this one... So we can... I get the rest of the island. And I have this one beaming this way as well. Alright, so let's head back. How much swimming do I want to do? You steel your courage against the long swim and plunge into the water. You try to sustain a regular stroke as you swim. Clouds begin to tumble across the inky sky. Soon it will be dark. From the island at your back there is a sudden violent scream. You look up to see a flash of flame rising to the sky. Crap. The Sightmaster. How did he come to be sergeant to a Sightmaster of this place? the bird, unless the birds carried him from there all the way over here. He can see far, he says. I don't know if we can swim. I don't know if it is too late. Too late for him or too late for us or both. It would seem the Sightmaster chose to look down when he opened his eyes. A dark shadow passes across the water. Let's dive under. I think it's fire. You waste no time. Whatever it is large, and you are vulnerable. You gulp a breath and dive under the water. The shadowy shape seems to hover above, circling. I lost a stamina. Really? So it's not fire, then? Alright, I'm gonna stay low. Okay, so it's a crazy bird again. You beat the water, holding your position. The shadow circles once more. Your breath is beginning to run short. Swim away. Now, this means swim away, as in swim away underwater, or come up and swim away. Shorter episode, right? Yeah, gonna leave it here. The Sightmaster. Poor guy. Alright, what do you guys think I should do? There's something... The shape seems to hover above. So unless it's a jet of flame or something, but it looks like he just... A flash of flame rising to the sky. Why would this happen in tune with the flash of flame if it's not flame itself? Right? Or are these, like, these are unrelated things? I don't know. So yeah, cast your votes below. Let me know what you guys think. Should I swim away? Should I stay down? My breath is beginning to run short. Staying down might help, but we're going to lose some stamina for sure. Or should I come up for air and risk whatever that is seeing us, hovering above us, waiting for us apparently to come up? So swim away, stay down, or come up for air. Thanks, guys, for watching. Thanks for voting. And endure. And enduring, grow strong. See you next week.